Hello?
Lucas Budlong, please.
It's for you.
Hello?
Budlong, is that you?
Yes.
This is Carl Sagan.
Carl Sagan? I think it's Carl Sagan.
Budlong, as you know, I've been assigned to the President's Committee on Extraterrestrials, the most important, none more secret committee.
No, I didn't know that.
Well, of course. And he has personally authorized me to instruct you to put Dr. Steve Mills back to work at Haddonkirk Laboratories tomorrow morning first thing.
Mills? But he almost blew the
place. Shut up, Budlong. No arguments. We can't afford to waste billions and billions of dollars. Have I made myself clear, Meathead?
Yes, well,
Well, I had just finished reading Carl Sagan's wonderful book, Intelligent Life in the Universe, written in about 1966, and had a tremendous respect for the ideas that I had seen there, which included the serious consideration for extraterrestrial life. And so Carl called one day and introduced himself, and I was honored, of course, because, you know, he was clearly more outranking than I was in terms of his profession at that time. and he said, I understand that you might be doing some work, and what would you want to talk about if we were asked to give a paper? And I said, well, Carl, one thing I wouldn't want to do is what everybody else is probably going to do, namely try to prove that they're real. I said, it's very clear to anybody who studies it at all that they're extraterrestrial. And the most important thing is to figure out how they work. So I would give a paper discussing the different avenues that one could explore in order to figure out how they work. And it was long silence on the phone, and he never invited me to give the paper. So at that, I did, however, attend the conference anyway, and heard everybody else who was there, and realized that at that time I began to ask myself, is there some plan to control this process? That was just a sort of a subconscious thought that I had in my mind, and I didn't really do much with it then.